Hey, boys and girls, welcome back to Persona 4 Golden. In the last episode, we finally figured out who's been behind the Midnight Channel kidnappings. And of all the people it could have been, it's actually the very first suspect that the police were looking into. And that is Namatame himself. And the reason why he was able to avoid the police for so long after the fact is due to the fact that he used the guise of a delivery truck driver, showing up at people's houses unannounced, and literally taking them to the Midnight Channel through a little TV in the back of his delivery truck. With that now known, we more than likely have found our Midnight murderer. But the thing is he's missing now, due to the fact that Nanako was taken by him last, and after the whole crash with Dojima and Namatame, Namatame has been missing since. And I have a good idea of where he could be. He's more than likely inside the Midnight Channel, but I don't think we'll see him this chapter. But we'll more than likely see him in a future chapter when we have to go back. But with that, we're actually going to be heading into the next dungeon of the game, and that is Nanako's dungeon, Heaven. And with that, let's go and save Nanako, since we did promise Dojima that we would definitely save her. And with that, we're also officially back from my vacation. It was actually pretty fun. I went to Discovery Cove, if anyone's still wondering where I went. So honestly, it was pretty cool. I got to see some dolphins, got to actually swim with the dolphin, which was pretty cool. But other than that, I think I'm ready to actually get back into our game. So yeah, I'm definitely going to be a little bit rusty, but I'm at least going to try my best. So with that, let's enter the TV world.
Alright, let's go.
Let's go indeed, Kanji. So into the TV world, and let's actually do this. Time to finally save Nanako, since it's been a couple days since I've actually got to play this, because I've been gone for, I think, 3, and then I also, the day that I got back, I could have recorded, but the thing is I had to reset up my camera since I was actually planning on taking pictures with the camera I use for recording. But the thing is I forgot the battery, and I forgot my phone, so I didn't even get to take any pictures. That was all done by my parents, so yeah, that was very unfortunate. So yeah, I had to reset up my camera and everything, and that takes a little bit of time since you need to find the perfect angles, and it's not exact, but it's about where it was before, I think. But let's see here. Look at this fog. Yeah, it is pretty bad.
Does this have something to do with all the fuss about the fog lately?
Maybe.
Something's weird in here. I think all the commotion in town has been affecting this world, too.
It definitely seems that way.
Well, we need to hurry now. Risei, can you tell us which direction Nanako-chan is in?
Yeah, which direction is she? Since we do know a lot about Nanako, and we're more than likely not going to have to search up anything about her to figure out where her dungeon is. And I already know that today is the day that you get in the dungeon, so we're perfectly fine on that. I just hope that they didn't, like, don't just throw you back outside is all.
I sense you that way. Wow, what's this warm feeling? Senpai, we need to save her.
Okay, we'll definitely do that. Well, we literally aren't taking the role as her big brother at this point, so there's literally no reason not to.
Let's go.
Okay, let's definitely go. So with that, let's finally see this Heaven dungeon, since we actually haven't gotten to take a look at it yet. Ooh, it definitely does look like Heaven, that's for sure. Wow, it's very, very bright. I'm not gonna lie, I actually like the decor of this place already.
This is Nanako-chan's? It's so beautiful. It's like a storybook. Vision of Heaven.
Yeah, it definitely does seem that way.
Like Heaven, huh? Deep down, Nanako-chan must really miss her.
I'm sure she does. She's an only child.
Yeah, she must definitely be missing her mom. In her heart of hearts, Nanako seems to have missed her deceased mother. Yeah, it definitely seems that way.
We have to do everything in our power to rescue her.
I'll need all of you. Yeah, that's definitely true. It's not just us.
Of course. We're gonna rescue Nanako-chan, no matter what.
Yeah, let's definitely do this.
We can find Namatame later. Let's give him what's come to him then. First, we need to rescue Nanako-chan.
Yeah, first off, first serve. So honestly, we'll find Namatame sometime soon. But with that, I'm actually gonna do a small cut since I have to reload a file due to the fact that I did do a little bit of training before this dungeon, just so we're kind of more level to this dungeon than we were previously, because I literally don't do any training episodes in between, so honestly, let's be honest, I definitely do need the training in between, so with that, I'll be right back. Okay, now that we actually now have the other save file all loaded and everything, I can actually show you what we have actually in store for today's episode. So these are the personas I've been actually working on, since due to the fact that I was actually able to make this, due to the fact that Hama Boost and Mahaman is actually really good, with a double invigorate for 2 and 3, with Miragi Dine with some fire amps and some mind charges. Honestly, a really good one there. But we also have Mother Harlot here, which is actually pretty good as well. And this is going to be the death version, due to the fact that you have dark and light for both of those one-shots. So in case one thing hits, is completely nullified, the other one will be able to use the other version of it, and it will more than likely get rid of the other enemy. So if we need to use those, we definitely have it. So with that, I believe we are ready. I will be using the throne, though, because honestly, I wanted to use that one, because I actually really like that design. But with that, I believe we are ready to actually get into the Heaven Dungeon. So let's do this.
Okay, good luck.
Okay, with Risei's good luck, I believe we are actually ready. So, let's finally see it. And I'm also wearing a couple costumes.
It's so quiet. What's this bad feeling I'm getting? Not a good chance. Just hang in there. We'll save you.
And with that, if you're actually wondering, we're wearing Chie's costume that we got from the Fox a long time ago. And we're also wearing an agent set for Naoto. And we're also wearing the Halloween costume for both Yukiko and for Spooks here. So, honestly, some pretty cool stuff. So honestly, definitely some stuff I'm really happy we got. Okay, based on mapping, it looks like maybe... actually I'm not sure. No, that definitely isn't where we need to go. That's leading us to a treasure chest, so that definitely wouldn't be the way. Mapping's very helpful in this game, honestly. Once you start getting, like, the better and better stuff for, Risei, you can definitely get some really good stuff. And also, I found out that through, like, levels, because I ended up finally checking out how good the levels are for your allies in this game, I ended up finding that Naoto actually gets severe almighty damage for every single person on the field, which is actually pretty good. Since the Megio skills are actually really, really strong, and they're honestly some of the best things you can actually get. Okay, so since we have a Hulk Hogan here with literally by himself, and we ended up just critting him, easy, I'll take it, honestly. Free level for Chie, which is also really good. I'm gonna stop counting out, like, how many stats we end up getting, since honestly, it really doesn't matter at this point in the game, because our stat points really don't matter as much nowadays, because of the fact that we're leveling so much nowadays that it really doesn't really matter. And also, the single stat increase doesn't really matter at the end of the day when we do have to, we usually reload the file to redo the dungeon completely so I'm not missing anything, because as I do whenever we get to a dungeon, because the whole point of the us going through it is that we're going through it normally, but we're not like running for every single item and things like that, so I definitely do not get some of the items due to the fact that we do all that. So honestly, I try my best, but you really can't get any of like the really good like weapon abilities if you're not paying attention. So definitely, it could definitely affect you, and it does. So me having that little bit of like leeway to actually focus on what I actually want to do is honestly really, really nice, since this game can definitely be really hard if you're not really focusing on that. Because we do definitely hinder ourselves when we run through a dungeon without leveling at all, and us just focusing on getting to the end. It definitely is a little bit more heart-raising than it would be for me to just run through the entire dungeon with you guys, but making multiple cuts in order so it's not like, you know. But it's easier for me to not have as many cuts and just keep going, due to the fact that it's easier for me to keep a cool and level head on what we're doing, and also it kind of helps it helps you guys know exactly what I want to do throughout the dungeon instead of me just cutting, and then I forget what I even talked about in certain aspects and stuff like that. So, honestly, I like these better.
I'm getting more and more anxious. I wonder why. Let's hurry, senpai.
Okay, let's definitely hurry. So far, nothing about Nanako or Namatame yet. Since usually we hear, dialogues from the people that are actually, the dungeons are actually sent for. So far, nothing specific. And honestly, I'm gonna say, since the fact that this just said it was not them, it was these guys, right? Fire. Okay, so let's just use Moragi died, since we do have Fire Amp. This is actually gonna be really, really strong. 600 damage is not bad. And then we can just auto for the rest of that, since there's no point in using a skill for that. And GG, shuffle time again. Actually, I'm very surprised we got that, since shuffle time has not been very friendly to me recently. So honestly, I'll take it if it's ever going to give it to me, but some HP and SP back is always nice. We actually have a new ability from Risei that actually gives us SP back after every battle, which is actually really good. It's called Relaxing Wave, and it's honestly really, really good. And we also have an HP version due to the fact that we got that during a, what do you call it, a social link that we did with her. Okay, so based on this, it looks like this might lead to the wrong way, so it looks like we should go left here instead. Or straight, actually, because there's no treasure chest this way, so it would lead to the stairs or wherever we're trying to go. So honestly, let's just go this way instead, since it definitely leads to where we want to go, and the... Oh, wait, what the heck? The shadow didn't actually chase me. That's different. Huh. I've never seen that happen before. The shadow actually completely changed paths. And actually, both of these led to the wrong way. So we're actually heading straight back to where we were. That's the one good thing about actually having this treasure tracker and enemy tracker. Since it easily helps you navigate these dungeons a little bit easier. And especially for the way we do it. Since we're trying to avoid needless battles that we don't need to do. Since, although it does kind of hinder you at some points, it is actually really nice to have. So it looks like this would lead to the exit. So we'll just slide by this golden hand and not accidentally run into it, due to the fact that if you run into it and it actually attacks you, and then it actually escapes immediately if you accidentally have that thing run into you, which is kind of weird, because you don't do it on purpose, because it's running from you, and it accidentally runs into you. It's actually not even on purpose. And then they knock you down instantly, and then they just escape, because they have every skill in the game, it seems like. So with that, honestly, yeah, stay away from the golden hands during videos, because they take quite a bit of time, and I've noticed that. So that's the reason why I stopped fighting those in videos. And if I end up running into one, I end up just skipping it. But honestly, yeah, golden hands are a big pain in the butt when it comes to actually editing. So let's see here.
I can definitely sense Nanako-chan's presence here. But, how do I put this? Something feels weird. This place really did come from Nanako-chan's heart, right? Then why does something feel off?
Strange. Why does something feel off, Risei? I guess, well, there's only one way to find out, and that's to continue going through here. I did say originally that, I didn't like the, the connotation that what this dungeon actually portrays, due to the fact that Nanako could die if we weren't to save her. So yeah, definitely could be bad. And since I just saw that these things are actually weak to light damage, I might as well just do it again. And GG. Oh, they're not weak to it, but the other one got one-shotted by it. So, well, at least we got that right this time around. Okay, so honestly, the skill card and the strength up would be nice. Actually, avoid encounters would have actually been nicer. But some strength and a sword card, which is Magurula. Okay, I'll take it. That's actually not a bad skill, but it could have been better, because there's definitely some really, really good skills that you can get. Okay, so based on mapping, looks like upward, actually, to be completely honest. But I could always be wrong, you never know. So honestly, we'll just try and see what happens. Okay, so we got a bunch of new enemies now. And also, I really like this weakness checker from Risei. So let's see here, 59. It's weak to fire, so we'll use that to our advantage. Use Miragi dying here, and burn everything that's on the field right now. And one hit? Cool. Fire amp is definitely helpful, due to the fact that that is heavy fire damage. So that's actually the most damage we can do at the exact moment, due to the fact that we don't have any severe damage yet. Although we will be getting that as soon as Naoto gets to her final level of that. Honestly, it will be nice once we get it, and that is a treasure chest, so we'll just slide back to this shadow instead, since I didn't even notice it, since the map's a little bit bigger than I was expecting when it came to that. Okay, so, okay. And due to the fact that we're using Naoto, honestly, using Wind here wouldn't be smart due to the fact that there's so many enemies. Honestly, let's just do heavy, almighty damage here, since, honestly, that's not the worst case scenario there. Okay, so far so good. And then maybe we can go for a Miragi Dine here to get rid of the other two enemies. And GG. Just like that, another enemy wave completely done. Got a level for Throne, which is always nice. Some Strength, Agility, and Luck, which is always good. And honestly, anything for that specific persona is actually pretty cool, since that is a persona I really do like. Due to the fact that I like the design, and also it kind of reminds me of one of the shadows that we've been fighting. The, upside down wheel bearing enemies that we fight every so often that are weak to physical damage. That's what it kind of reminds me of. I don't know what the exact name of the because that's supposed to be, isn't that like a torture device what they're on? I don't actually know the actual name for the torture device that they're actually on, to be honest. I think it's what it does is it like grabs you by the arms and the legs. And I think you're supposed to turn a wheel, and then it pulls the arms and legs. It's all the way from back, like, what do you call it? Back in old, England days. So basically, Black Plague kind of days. Definitely a very cruel design for a thing, but that thing's definitely not based on that. I think it's more based on something else. But let's see here.
I can hear her. This must be Nanako-chan's voice. She's saying something, but it's too quiet to make out. Senpai, please find where the voice is coming from.
Okay, we can definitely do that. But yeah, I think the throne specifically, when the enemy, the shadow is definitely based on that. But the throne enemy is actually based on a different aspect of, what do you call it? I don't know what religion it's based on, but it's more based on a religion than the torture device, as you can see with the design. Because it's not strapped up to the wheel, it's actually, what do you call it? Like, kind of like riding the wheel. More like a, I don't actually know, actually. I've never actually taken quite a good look at that, actually. Maybe I should. You know what? We'll do a quick look at it, just because you can easily check out things if you know how to. I guess, you can't actually check the, I thought you could actually check the, stuff on it, but you can't check it on the field. That's kind of weird. Yeah, he's not actually strapped to it, he's just holding on to it, so yeah, he's definitely not based on the old torture device, but the enemies are definitely, since they're definitely strapped to it. They got ropes attached to them and everything, and they definitely don't look like they're having a fun time on it. But yeah, that's what that definitely reminds me of, to be honest, and honestly, I don't know why that's their design, but it is cool that they have multiple different designs in the game and not one shadow. Well, there is a couple recolors of certain shadows, but a lot of them are designed in their own ways. But you can also definitely find some ones that are reskins. But that isn't a bad thing due to the fact that if you make too many enemies, you wouldn't know exactly what to do. And it also kind of gives you an idea of what skills might be strong against it, and what you shouldn't use this time around in order to actually hit its weakness. But with that, let's actually see how Nanako's doing, since she's actually popping up now.
Mom. That's Nanako-chan's voice.
Yeah, that is.
Mom, where are you? Why did you disappear? Why did you leave me? No, come back. Are these Nanako-chan's feelings? But I'm not lonely, I have dad with me. I know he's always been late coming home, and he never plays with me because he's so busy. He can't cook or do laundry either. He tries to be nice, though. He's a little scary sometimes. But I love him. Big Bro is with me now, too. So I'm not alone. I'm not lonely.
Definitely doesn't sound completely, like, correct, because of the fact that she still sounds like she is lonely, and she's trying to make herself not sound like it is. But she definitely sounds like she's still lonely, which is kind of sad, since we already know what happened there, and there's nothing that can be changed, unless, you know, rewrite of history. But honestly, I don't think that's going to happen in this game, since that is, unless Persona 5 got that from P4, but honestly, yeah, I don't think that's going to be coming back, to be honest.
Little kid, tell her so she's not lonely, so she doesn't fall apart.
You idiot, we'll ruin everything if we act all sad. We gotta greet her with a smile.
Nana-chan.
Yeah, Nana-chan indeed. All we gotta do is find her, though. Make sure she's safe. Oh, what's the matter?
Something's not right. There's someone here besides Nanako-chan. It was fate at first, so I couldn't tell for sure, but there's definitely another person here. And whoever this is, their power's getting stronger.
Could it be Namatame? Did he dunk in here after being cornered by, like, Mitsuo?
Definitely, 100%. Perhaps so. It seems as if he was particularly determined to kidnap Nanako-chan.
But why? If he's a real culprit, he must know the dangers coming into this world.
I don't know. But if it is him, he may have entered from the TV near the site of the accident. Perhaps even the TV is his trunk. Which means Nanako-chan may be in grave danger. We must hurry.
Definitely so. So with that, let's continue going in. So we might actually see Namatame then, due to the fact that the party thinks that he might be here with them. Which is actually kind of scary to think about, since now we have to kind of worry about the Midnight Murderer and saving Nanako. And due to the fact that he's a full-on person, he can actually completely stop us if he really tried. And if he had a weapon, that would definitely be very dangerous. Because if he is the Midnight Killer, he would more than likely have one, right? And he wouldn't just be here completely unarmed, right? So yeah, we should definitely be careful. And of course, there's another wave of enemies. That doesn't happen often, but it does happen some only during episodes, which is kind of weird. I don't understand that. Oh, actually, that was good. We almost got all of them. 60% chance is not bad. Plus the Hama boost, but I'm not sure how much that gives us. Honestly, some really, really nice skills that we're getting now, since one-shot abilities are honestly the best skills in these games. And the enemies use it on you, so there's no reason not to have it on yourself, right? So we're only literally evening out the playing field, and I see a golden chest, but there's a shadow next to it, so it's not really as worth. Let's see here. It looks like this, nope, that's definitely not the way we're going. And based on the shadow's position, I have a feeling he's guarding the exit. And I accidentally swung that sword way too early, and we ended up getting it right. Okay, so what are these things weak to? Oh, physical. Huh, okay then. But we already have an enemy that's weak to... Oh, never mind. I was thinking that we were going to be using something else, but you know what? We're going to use Blight here instead, since that's full-on physical on everybody, and also it lets us hit them.
Oh, can I have this one?
Yeah, and definitely. Galactic Punt one of them into the skies, since we haven't had that in a long time. Aw, we didn't get one of our allies to do their scooter skills. I've been hoping to actually get that, and there's actually another type that I accidentally ran into in between episodes. If you can actually get it to go on, two of your people on field will actually use an ability. And I haven't been able to get it to actually show up yet, but it's actually pretty cool, because then you actually get like multiple people to attack. I believe it was called Double Dragon, and it was with Yukiko and Chie. And they actually team up and they actually do like an almighty attack on the field. I don't know if it's almighty, but I think it is. You hear voices from somewhere.
No, that's not it. I just wanted to live peacefully. That's it.
Nanako-chan's presence is being drowned out. Please answer us, Nanako-chan. Don't worry, we're on the way to rescue you right now.
That's definitely Namatame's voice then, because there's no way that just some random dude is in here. So yeah, definitely Namatame and Nanako. But what is he rambling about now, since he definitely likes to ramble, that's for sure. But honestly, we have no clue what he's doing and why. Okay, so based on this, it looks like a left here, or the previous area that we were at. But you never know. The treasure tracker isn't specifically easy to tell exactly where we need to go at all times. Ooh, these little wind enemies again. These little tables were in the original dungeon. Okay, so those guys are weak to fire. That's actually good to know. So Miragi 9 is actually perfect here. Okay, throw and burn everything to a crisp, and GG. And even if he didn't, he would be able to use a second attack and another level for Neodo, getting closer and closer to Makarakarn. But honestly, I don't think I need that skill, to be honest, but we might grab it if I end up changing my mind, right? So honestly, we might end up using it. And okay, so this way area was the wrong way. Okay, well, we just head on back then, because there's literally no reason to head this way now, since there's no reason to go for those treasure chests for two reasons. One, they might not have anything in them, and they might be all green chests, let's be honest. So yeah, definitely just head on back to where we were. Okay, just smack the shadow in the back for the priority. And, oh, these guys. Okay, so these little balance enemies. Honestly, I'm gonna try and see if we can use Mahamon here, because this definitely does help. And it might end up being what they're weak to. Nope, they're blocking it. Good to know. Okay, so Megadola, since we know that will hit them no matter what, since you can't block it, which is good. But apparently you can resist it, which is kind of weird. I don't know how that works, but some enemies actually do resist the almighty hits in this game, and I don't understand that one, to be honest. And I don't know why that would be the case, but it is definitely weird, I'll be honest. But shuffle time is always nice to see. I actually don't think skill level up actually works on us. So we're just going to go for the XP bonus, since literally everything's already ranked up, to be honest. So yeah, we can't even use the skill level up on Throne, even if we wanted to. So the XP is literally the only thing I could use there, since the HP and SP regain actually doesn't even really matter as much anymore, since we have relaxing waves. And also the HP variant that Rise gave us in her social links.
This place is nice. It's so quiet. I wish I could have lived here. Together with...
Together? Is he with Nanako-chan? This isn't good, Senpai. Let's hurry on.
What is he doing? Oh, hey, Golden Hand. That actually makes it easier, since we just have to kind of just stay away from him, and we don't end up running into him on accident. He kind of actually helps us traverse this, since they usually don't have enemies too close to Golden Hands. And if they do, the enemies are really kind of like widely spread apart for the most part, so that actually gave us quite a bit of distance in this floor, to be honest. So honestly, I'll take that, and that looks like a new enemy. I don't think I've seen the tree guys before, but we've definitely seen these little, what do you call them? These little sigil guys. But let's see here. So we got these blossom guys. Blossom makes me think that fire would be good here, but honestly, Megadola's just better. So honestly, let's just go for that instead, since we already know it's going to do some decent damage. Okay, so far so good. I'm going to try smacking him, and GG. Just like that. Just wipe the entire party, since there's no reason to use any spells at that point. Honestly, let's just grab Uriel, since we don't have that persona. Just grab it for free, since there's no reason not to grab it. And we can also use it for fusion later, in case we need any cool spells or any kind of abilities we might need for later. Okay, so based on this, right takes us down to a treasure, left takes us to where we need to go. So now we just need to kind of slide by that, go towards this shadow here, get him from the back, and let's see here. Okay, that is new. Okay, so here we go, we finally got some new stuff. So, I'm gonna try Mahamon here,
Because some things are actually weak to light damage, so they actually always get hit by it. Okay, he blocks it. And thankfully, we don't have to worry about rebounds now, since due to the fact that our light damage is nulled. So if it gets rebounded to us, it will get completely blocked, which is good. Okay, so due to the fact that we don't know what you're weak to, let's just go for fire then. Since you look metal, so it looks like, nope, you don't take fire damage from, like, weakness damage, which is kind of unfortunate. But honestly, we'll find it eventually, right? And down he goes. Well, random Boofla ended up getting rid of him. And I actually found out something. Chie doesn't get the next version of Bufu, which is Bufu Dine. She only gets it during her scooter events, which is kind of unfortunate. But there's really nothing I can do about that. So let's just deal some new cards and see if we can maybe get a shuffle time out of this. Lose one dealt card. And got rid of the wrong one, so let's just go for Magic Up, since that'll definitely be helpful. Since we can just use Maragidine and do some big damage. But definitely unfortunate. I was kind of hoping we get to keep the Arcana one, while also keeping the Lose Dealt Card one, but it ended up not being the case, which is definitely unfortunate. We're also getting to the last couple skills for Risei and Himiko. And it looks like the next one's going to be 100% chance on escaping, which is actually really nice. But I haven't really had to do any of that since battles aren't too dangerous. Well, we aren't playing on an easier difficulty, but it definitely isn't needed on this difficulty. If you're playing on like hard or very hard, I definitely say it would be a good thing to have.
I discovered the new world. I must save people. Yes, only I can.
This voice is getting closer. We're almost there. Hang on in there, senpai.
Okay, let's definitely do so. So this dungeon is actually only 10 floors, so we're actually almost to the end. Because 7, 8, 9, and literally we're on the 10th floor and then we're done. So honestly, we're actually really close. And talking about the torture device enemy, there's one, the Cyclops. Okay, so these guys are actually weak to fire. I think the giant scarecrow enemy is actually... No, he isn't. Okay, I'll take that. And the other thing actually dodged, so we're just going to use Aggie here to get an all-out attack for free.
Is this our chance?
Yes, it is. Go all in and knock him out. We actually need to get Naoto's all-out attack, since we haven't had that one yet. But we'll get that eventually, right? So we'll end up running into an enemy that we end up getting to do that for. Ooh, I actually just noticed something. So lose one earned card, that will get rid of the no XP, and then we can just grab the rest, and we get everything we want. All goods, since the new no XP is actually gone due to the fact that we got that star. The card of the Fortune Arcana for some luck. Some new sword card, which is Electric Amp, which is really good. And some wand, which means more experience. Always, always nice. And also I found out that you can actually change the amount of EXP you gain in the battles and how much money you get. So I honestly might end up using that from now on when we do when I'm training in between episodes, to kind of speed up the process of that, since it does actually take quite some time to actually go through all the training there. What the heck? There's just an enemy in there with no treasure chest. That's kind of weird. Okay then. So it's more than likely a right here, so let's just go straight into this door instead. And let's see here.
Turn back. Stop getting in my way.
Open the door and enter. Sure, okay. We're already at the halfway point then. And here's our midway boss.
Why are you getting in my way? I'm going to save this girl.
What do you mean by save? We still don't know what you mean by that. You keep saying that, but honestly, I don't think that's the case. Maybe he doesn't know what's going on with the Midnight Channel. Maybe he's just crazy. Or honestly, who even knows at this point? But I'm going to go for a mind charge here, since that would definitely be good. We're going to do a multiple different charges here, since we have multiple different abilities for that, since we're actually using the characters to actually get all these charge skills. So honestly, it's nice to have those, but ouch. Why'd you have to have fire? Okay, he's going for another mind charge. Thankfully, his mind charge and fire actually didn't do that much damage, which is surprising. Okay, so we're gonna go for Agudine here, since that's actually perfect. Do quite a bit of damage there. 337 is not bad. Thankfully, we have everyone that can recover people on field, so literally we don't have to worry about that. And since we actually did do the Mind Charge with Neodo, we can just go Mega Dodla here, and this will be heavy Mind Charge damage, which is really nice. 522, not bad. And then we can also go for an Agudine here with a Fire Hand, which means this is going to do 940 damage. Down goes the mini-boss. GG. And we also got a level for Throne. I thought that was a level for Spooks for a second. Honestly, it would have been nice. Definitely would have been nice.
I'm worried about Nanako-chan. Senpai, let's hurry on.
Yeah, it's definitely hurry. She's definitely must be scared, let's be honest. We promised her that she wouldn't get attacked by the Midnight Killer and we'd protect her no matter what. And we kind of failed on that front. So yeah, we definitely need to catch up to her at some point anytime soon. Because she's definitely not having a good time, is she? Okay, it looks like this might be the way we want to go. So yeah, I see a door in front of us, so this would be the exit. Okay, cool, we found it. We just need to get past this wave of shadows here. And also, I found out the shadows actually exist in the Shin Megami universe as well, which is kind of cool. Due to the fact that they're actually one of the demons you can fight, which is actually kind of cool. So both games kind of interlap and into each other. Because originally, the Persona games were made as basically more lighthearted versions of the Shin Megami games, but also a what-if scenario. So honestly, it's really cool to actually see some small, interlaps between the series, although they don't use the shadow enemies that often. I think they only really used it in one game. It definitely would be cool to see them make an appearance again, because it's definitely a really cool thing to see that both games do kind of, have similarities in between them, since they are made by the same developer, and they were basically made to be this is this and this is that, but they both are coexisting at the same time, but in different realities kind of thing. I definitely do like that. The card of Temperance, which means we get chest key, some more XP, and a lot of coins, which means we're definitely getting a big payout. Not bad. 2,000 yen for one battle is not bad whatsoever. It's basically a fifth of the money we get just for working Shu for one night. Definitely not bad, and much easier to get than working with Shu every single night, since he isn't available every single night, so definitely nice to get.
I won't hand over this girl, no matter what, this time for sure.
What is he going to do? Commit suicide with Nanako-chan? Oh, no, that's not the time to be worrying about. What's he got planned? We just need to focus on getting Nanako-chan back safe.
Yeah, definitely so, and why'd you have to say that? Now I'm even more freaked out. This guy's gonna do something really, really messed up with Nanako soon. And now that you say that, okay. Also, I noticed that these little giant enemies actually hold those little balance enemies, which is kind of funny. Also, what'd that say he was weak to? Wind, okay. Really? Wind? Okay then. Well, since there's too many enemies and that only is a one hit, we're just gonna do Mega Dodla since it's just safer. Okay, so far so good. We could go for Maragudine here since I'm not sure if everything's gonna be weak to Mahamon. And I don't want to just spam Mahamon, honestly. So we're just trying to not just one-shot every enemy and actually try and work on focusing on their actual weaknesses instead, since I could easily just spam Mahamon if I really, really wanted to, let's be honest. So due to the fact that I believe we won't need Invigorate as much, I believe we can take this. You know what? Maybe. I don't know. We'll keep it for now, honestly. Let's keep Invigorate for now, see what else we can get, and then honestly, we'll figure out from there what we actually want to keep and what we want to throw away. Okay, so based on positioning of this dungeon, it looks like this might lead to the exit, so let's run straight towards this red shadow that's more than likely going to be pretty dangerous, and it definitely looks dangerous with Tank 4.0. Oh my goodness, these tank enemies. These little arcane tanks keep showing up, and they just get stronger and stronger. And this time it's a, oh, it's weak to wood. Okay. I see Mahamon in its future due to the fact that this is 100% a one-shot on that thing. So let's just do it. Just get rid of it, and now we can focus on the knights. Okay, so knights, they block the light damage, so go for Maragidon there. Or, did I say Maragidon? That's the medium damage, isn't it? Or Maragidine, there we go. That's perfect. I accidentally said it completely wrong. I think these might actually resist this, actually. Yep, they do, because they seem like they resist physical damage, because their original counterparts do. Okay, well, that's unfortunate. So there's my proof on almighty damage being resistant at some points. Okay, cool. Definitely unfortunate, but honestly, we still got rid of them before they could do anything. Okay, I see another free shuffle type, so we're just going to take that for free. Don't need any more personas since we're perfectly fine where we are right now. And honestly, as I said, I'm going to go back through anyways and make sure I grab some items and make sure we're not too far behind. But yeah, definitely, we don't need the personas now. We'll grab them later when I go back through. Okay, this guy's big, so he's going to be much stronger than the previous enemy. Oh, nope, he looks easier. And they're using blades, they got a critical on me, which means they're going to attack again. Okay, Tempest Slash isn't that bad. It's heavy damage, but it's not too bad, though. Okay, well, honestly, Megidola did do some decent damage. It's basically 300 damage.
I couldn't defeat it.
Technically, if you count both of them combined, but it could be better, honestly. We already know that they completely negate one-shots from that, so let's be smart. He's going for Blight, which means poison on everyone, which definitely could be a problem. But now that we have Rampage going, we should be fine. And I probably should heal really, really soon, since Chie is kind of, not really feeling too great right now, is she? Okay, so let's see here. I see two new personas, though. Okay, one lose card, which is really good. We can grab these two, and then, honestly, deal new card, see what we get. Wait, is that a double Garuda? That's actually kind of funny. You usually don't see that. Well, we'll just grab the money up, since there's no reason to grab a second one, since the other one will just get deleted, so there's no points. Okay, not bad. I'll take both of those, two personas, which, although we will lose, since we already know what's going to happen, is I'm going to reload the save and redo this, but definitely a nice gesture. Definitely really nice. Okay, well, we couldn't fully heal Chie there, since I didn't want to waste too much of Yukiko's... I'm trying to dodge that guy because I don't want to fight every single thing on the field. Let's be honest, because it does waste a little bit of time if you fight every single monster, and that is a treasure chest, so that means we just come back this way. Okay, we'll fight you then. I changed my mind. I want to fight you now. Okay, so these guys were weak to wind, right? So, yeah, they were. Okay, so yeah, Garudine would be perfect here. I just had to remember because, wait, what? Are they not? Oh, lights. Okay, I misread it. I forgot. I got it mixed up with a different enemy that it told us that it was wind, but we know that it's light, so free one-shot. I think they can't block it either. I think if you're weak to that specific one-shot, you actually do get one-shotted. Okay, restores the full party's HP, so let's just get rid of the moderate version. And there we go, full heal for everybody. That's not bad, and I see a Maragidine in the future, so we already know what Maragidon is getting completely and utterly wiped out or something else, which is also very nice. Okay, so far so good, and this looks like the wrong direction. What's with these enemies that are just the hands of those giant sentinel giant monsters? Let's see here, he's weak to wind. Okay. And isn't the other variant also weak to wind? That's kind of funny. Okay, well, let's just go for a Megidola, since we already know that's going to do some decent damage. And then we can... let's see here. I was just thinking if it could be weak to Mahamon here, but there's no real reason to do so. So let's just go Maragidine here, since there's no reason not to use it. And then we can just smack the last guy. And GG. I just wanted to make sure that we weren't going to, like, mess up there and they... somehow reflect it or something, and well, we're not gonna get one-shotted by a reflection, but it's just a matter of the fact that it would waste a little bit of time if we did it incorrectly is all. Okay, so it looks like we're going back, so wow. Literally, the first door we could have gone in was literally the direction we needed to go. Well, it happens sometimes, and I don't usually specifically think of that, because usually the first door that's on field usually isn't where you're wanting to go. So that is definitely unfortunate that it happened to be that this time around. Hey, look, the same enemies we just fought. But this time, we got the technically a mini Pryo here, since I think they kind of, oh no, resave. Okay, never mind, they didn't have any kind of Pryo here, because the fact that I got Risei's scanning of them mixed up with their attack, because I'm not used to Risei telling me weaknesses, since that just started happening very, very recently. And that was just because when I was doing my training, I just unlocked it. So yeah, definitely not used to it yet, and I'll get used to it eventually, but it is something new, and I'm definitely, it's nice to have, honestly, because then you know what they're actually weak to, but it does kind of pull your concentration a little bit off of what you're talking about, or trying to think about at that exact moment, because now you're like, oh, this thing's weak to this now, when you're talking about a different topic on top of that.
I'm scared. Where are you, Mom? Dad, save me. I can hear Nanako-chan's voice. Senpai, she's just up ahead.
Just one more floor, and then we finally get to Nanako and more than likely Namatame. He might not be here, but we are hearing his thoughts, so it would be weird that he wouldn't be here. I'm just gonna go for the free Mahamon here, since the arcane tanks are actually dangerous, so there's no reason to keep that on field, right?
Oh, time for this bear to lend a paw.
And this is the first time we finally got a cavalry attack in an episode. That is right. Because, what do you call it? I was thinking that maybe we got, Yosuke's, but we ended... No, actually, we might have, actually. I might have completely forgot. But yeah, definitely just nice in general to get it. Because I've been really wanting to see those, and there's, for some reason, it doesn't happen as often as I would think it would. And we don't do much damage to these knight guys, even though magic damage is like their main weakness, which is kind of weird. I think they're majorly weak to darkness, so I could have thrown out the Mother Harlot, but there's no reason to really throw that out and do 60 SP of damage in one turn, to be honest. There really is no reason to do that. And it looks like maybe upwards might be the way we want to go, due to the fact that all the treasure's on the right side. And left side really doesn't make sense to have a random path towards treasure, right? I could be wrong, but honestly, I just feel like this might be right. And it looks like I am right, since this looks like it leads to a double door, which usually is the exit. And it is. Okay, cool. We already made it to the end of the dungeon. So with that, I'll be right back. I'm going to go do a small retrain through this dungeon, make sure everything's all right. As I said, I'm going to turn up the money gain and the EXP gain to make it a little bit easier. And then we're also going to make sure to grab all the items I need. So with that, I'll be right back, and I'll see you guys very, very shortly. Okay, with our small cut all done and over, and a small training session all done, I actually have our new personas for this fight. So we have Mada, which is going to have a bunch of different heavy magical skills for us to use, with Fire Amp and Wind Amp being a decent thing to have, and we also have Fire Boost as well, which is really good. So 75% extra damage from fire moves is definitely nice. We also have Melch. I don't know how to... Melch is a deck. I don't know how you exactly say that. But this is going to be our physical user with some decent skills here. But he also has Zyodyne, but we really don't need that part. But honestly, really good as well. And then I have a random Barong because I couldn't get rid of him. So he's just going to be fodder for later. And honestly, some decent fodder at that. So with that, I believe we are ready. And for wondering about the rest of the team, the rest of the team is at 76 for Chie. Risei is level 79 now, and she has all her skills, which is actually pretty cool. She ended up getting Vigor Song, which means the party gets 10% of their SP back. And we also have a certain escape, which makes it so pretty much... Oh, it's not all... Okay, so it's almost all battles. I actually didn't read this. Huh, okay then. I was actually thinking that would be all battles, but... Okay then. Well, that's still good. Well, most battles will be able to escape now. And then we have Naoto level 78, and then Yukiko is at level 78 as well, with some decent skills as well. So honestly, not bad at all. So honestly, I believe we are ready, so let's see how this boss battle ends up going.
Oh, there she is! None of good chance is behind these gates.
Open the door and enter. And with that, let's do it. That's a yes. Let's go finally save Nanako and get her out of this heaven dungeon and get her just to safety. And there he is. Namatame was indeed here. I wasn't for sure, but, well, there he is.
Big bro.
You mustn't go.
Are you Namatame?
You know me.
Taro Namatame. It's definitely him. Then he did come in here. Yeah, he definitely did. And he is wearing his delivery truck driver suit. So that all adds up then.
Huh, so you're the killer.
Let go of her.
You're the ones I saved. Don't worry, I'll save this girl too.
Is this dude high or something? Quit talking shit and let go of the girl.
Don't come near me.
Nanako-chan.
That doesn't look like saving to me, Namatame.
Calm down, Kanji-kun. We can't predict his behavior. We have to keep on talking. If we can discern his intentions, perhaps we can somehow deal with him.
True? Nanako is in danger. You should choose your words very carefully. Why are you doing this? Yeah, why are you?
To save them.
Nanako is in danger. Okay, well, we already know that. What is the Midnight Channel?
People needing to be saved appear. That's why I put them in the TV.
Okay. Let's ask it again, see if it says anything different.
People needing to be saved appear. That's why I put them in the TV.
I'm gonna keep saying it. It says that... Okay. Why even give me the chance? Okay, that makes no sense. Well, let Nanako go, because I'm not gonna keep repeating those answers and get no answers, so literally there's no other point.
No. We must pull his attention away from Nanako-chan.
Well, I couldn't choose anything else.
You've put the people you saw on the TV Night Channel into the world. This world, am I correct? They all want to be saved.
Did I ever ask you to save me?
And you didn't save us, dammit. It was the exact opposite.
If I hadn't put you in the TV, how would you have ended up?
How would we... Are you trying to say we wouldn't have been able to face ourselves? What? But we nearly died.
Yes, exactly.
You kidnapped them, yes or no?
Yes. Why did you target the local residents who became known through the media? Why do you know these people? Why do these people appear on the Midnight Channel?
On rainy nights, on TV, they signal me to say save them.
You keep saying save this and save that. Are you saying murdering people is your idea of saving them?
Murder? No, I'm saving them.
Yeah, totally, dude.
How's it different, huh? All you're doing is killing people.
If you go on to think of that, go ahead. I know you chased us all the way here to kill. Well, too bad. I'm gonna save her.
No.
You asshole, you're not gonna get away with this.
Shut the hell up.
Uh-oh, that does not look good. Okay, wait, what? Wait, I've never seen that happen before. He turned into a shadow. Huh, okay then. Wait, was that never the real Namatame then?
What a wonderful world. An unknown, unreachable place, filled with pleasant fog. And I'm a savior. It's filthy over there. So many evildoers. That's why I'm doing this, to save them. I'm a savior, a righteous hero.
He's kind of shadow. Big bro, I can't breathe. Nanachan.
Yeah, we definitely need to get rid of this dude.
Let's do this.
It looks like we're rushing him then. Well, at least we got him off of her.
No, senpai.
Okay, let's go and get her. There we go. Nanako secured. Now we just gotta deal with Namatame.
Nano-chan.
Nanako-chan. Nanako-chan. Bastard. How dare you?
Give her back. I'm going to save her.
And I don't think you're saving her, dude. And there it is. That is Namatame then. Okay then. And his shadow definitely does not look happy.
I'm going to save her. Don't interfere.
How solid is his grasp on reality? Wait, also I just noticed something. His shirt, or gown, or whatever he's wearing, literally says peace and love. Okay, dude, you're definitely not helping anyone with peace and love. Let's be honest here. Okay, so honestly, I'm not sure what he would be weak to, so I'm just gonna go with Agidyne here, since it is a single, a hit per thing. Okay, 539 is not bad. Yeah, I'll take that. Okay, honestly, I think we should just smack him as much as possible, so since we know that Agidyne does do damage, so let's just have... Oh, it missed completely. Well, that's unfortunate. Okay, so... honestly, the best thing I can think of here is just going severe God Hand damage with the free Tarukaja that we get for free. Never mind, it missed again. What is this? Wait, does this guy have, like, max, dodge chance or something? Okay, that could be a problem. Well, let's go for another Agidyne since three of our units have it, so there's no point in not using it since we do know that it does do damage. Oh, and he does actually attack everyone on field now. Okay, so we actually haven't run into that before, so we actually do need to be a little bit careful. And this guy with his dodging, okay then, dude. Can you chill on the dodging? Because that's actually a little annoying since it does kind of hinder how much we can actually attack you. Okay, so far so good. Hopefully God's Hand actually hits this time since it is severe damage. I would like to actually hit him. Okay, 455 damage. Good, good, good. And then we can just go for an Agidyne here, and that should be a decent amount of damage. I think he's probably going to be like two phases, probably, because if he were to be just one phase, it would be too easy. So definitely, I think he's going to be like one of these ones that actually changes, because we haven't run into anything of the sort yet, and I know these games like to do that, so I'm pretty sure he would be the first one to do that, right? Since he is the Midnight Murderer and all, so it would make sense he would be a little different from everyone we fought so far. I'm pretty sure our Tarukaja is finally wearing off now, so let's power charge up so we can use a maxed out God's Hand the next turn. Okay, so far so good. No one's doing bad on HP except for Chie, so I think we're fine there. Then we can just go for Agidyne here, since there's no reason not to use it. Okay, 396.
Save her. I'm going to save her.
Quad coverage. Okay, here we go. This definitely doesn't seem like a normal move. Okay, the atmosphere changed. Okay. Nothing's apparent, so I don't think it was an attack. So I'm guessing it's probably kind of like, what was her name? Excellius from Tokyo Mirage Sessions, where she was able to change her weaknesses. So I'm guessing this guy has different weaknesses now. So I'm gonna go with that, since that kind of sounds familiar. Okay, so I'm guessing, due to the fact that how Excellius worked, it went from being weak to magical skills to being weak to physical. and vice versa. So I'm guessing none of these are actually going to be good now, so maybe we should go to our physical guy now. Just in case, you never know. Okay, so far so good. We could go for a power charge here, which would be smart. So let's honestly do that real quick. Okay, so far so good. And then we can have Naoto go for either Vorpal Blade or Tempest Slash here. And honestly, I'm going to say that we should probably just do Tempest Slash, just to be safe, and this will definitely tell us. Okay, now he takes 140 damage, not bad, not bad. And then we can go for God's Hand, since we did charge them, and there's no reason not to use it. And 1,105 damage is not bad whatsoever. And let's try Aggie here. I don't know what it did, I was just guessing. We still don't know, okay. I was thinking that might be the case, but it may not even be the case. Okay, so since we did do a power charge, let's go for this now. Akasha Arts, which does 2 damage and heavy damage, which is pretty good. So hopefully we get the double hit here, since that would be nice. And we only did 462. That's unfortunate. Okay, well, another Tempest Slash, since we do know it's going to do some decent damage. And then we'll go for a Salvation to heal everybody, since everyone is kind of way too low now. So we'll just do a power charge for Chie to make sure she's all charged up for next turn. And then Salvation to give everybody their HP back. And if you're wondering what the secondary effect of it is, it's actually to revive our takeoff ailments as well, which is really nice. So basically it's Amarita and full heal on top of it. Okay, that's some damage actually. Wow, that was, 400, 450 or 500 damage right there, all in one attack. Definitely kind of scary. I'm going to go for Ashka Arts again, since it seems like it would be... Wow, he really likes dodging. Okay, well, I guess we're not doing that. Okay, another Tempest Slash then, since we do need to hit him at least. Okay, well, at least we're kind of hitting him. I'm going to hope that God's Hand actually hits him here, though, because it seems like he likes dodging, and we don't need him to be dodging every single attack, right? Okay, another Aggie should be fine here. Hopefully it hits. And it is indeed exactly like Exelius. Okay, so he completely blocks out a lot of it. Which definitely does affect us, but we should be pretty much fine there, right? Let's see here. We could take one for the team here. I'm gonna say we should, so let's go Media Harn here. This would be a full heal for everybody. And also gives Yukiko another turn. And honestly, our character can't really do much here right now, so there's no point in really waiting till Yukiko. So honestly, we're just trying to do as much as we can. I'm gonna try Megi Dolan here, just to see how much damage it does, since it is Almighty and he can't resist it. So let's just see how much damage it actually does. 240? Okay, basically the Tempest Slash, which is actually pretty nice. Let's go for another God's Hand, since there's no reason not to. He's actually getting closer and closer to actually going down. Okay, so far so good. No one's low on HP, so let's just go for a normal attack now. 98 damage. Control. What are you controlling, dude? Oh, he's going for my allies. Okay, then. How does this work? Okay, do I have anything that nulls physical attacks? Because that does not seem like something I need to be getting hit by. Not really. I'm gonna say we should probably guard here. I just don't trust my allies, not trying to attack me. Okay, so far, okay, one of them is attacking me, and he's also trying to attack me. So let's just guard for our life until these guys are no longer being manipulated. Because I don't think I can just pull them out, and that is severe physical damage. Ouchies! Please stop attacking me. And wait a minute. Wait. Really? That's not very fair. Wow, that's the first time I've actually lost during boss fights. Well, I'll be right back once we actually get back to that part of the fight. Wow, that's actually the first time that's ever happened. Okay then. Okay, since I believe we're back to where we were this time around, and also I found out I had Marukaja, which I could have used, which would have definitely helped when actually fighting this dude. I should have also probably figured that out by then, but it definitely did help this time around, so I'm actually back here quite a bit faster than I would have been normally. Okay, so far so good. He hasn't done control yet, but I have a feeling he's more than likely about to. But the thing is I don't think I don't know if we'll be able to actually, like, stop him beforehand. So, honestly, he could easily just do that again. But hopefully he doesn't do that, if you know what I mean. I wish it wasn't a full-on thing. I don't think they should be able to use my abilities. I think that is completely messed up. Due to the fact that, Chie has that whole, severe damage for a reason. So, yeah, I don't think I... definitely don't like the fact that they can just do that. But, yeah, you know, it's nothing I can really do. I'm gonna hope that he's more than likely not being full-on coveraged anymore, and thankfully it wasn't the case. Okay, perfect. Okay, he doesn't even need to use the control this turn, which is good. Okay, down goes Namatame, Shadow, and GG. Just like that. Down goes the so-called savior. What do you think about that?
Damn it. Why?
Why indeed? Why did you do it? Is the real question.
Nanako-chan.
What about Nanako? She okay?
She looks like she's in pain, but she doesn't seem to be injured anywhere. This place must not be good for her. We need to carry her out, quick.
Okay, quick. Pick her up, and let's get on out of here, quick. And we can use a Goho M, actually, to be completely honest. Since that is a good way to get on out of here. It's literally instant.
Oh, we should take him with us as well.
Yeah, we definitely should. Yeah, we can't just leave him here, I guess. Yeah, and plus he'd die as well, because the shadows would turn on him now. Due to the fact that if he's here by himself, he's got no way of getting out.
Nanako-chan, hang in there.
Nanako isn't waking up. Uh-oh, she in a coma now? That's not good.
What are we gonna do?
Honestly, no clue.
She's so small, she was stuck in there for so long. And then there was this weird fog, dammit.
Strength, true.
The police and paramedics will be here shortly.
Cool, good. One guy going to prison and one girl going to the hospital. And that's all we need now. Wish she wasn't strangling Nanako, though. Oh, I'm a savior, let's just strangle a little kid. That does not seem like saving, dude. Inaba Municipal Hospital in front of Nanako's room. Nanako isn't allowing any visitors. Why not?
Nanachi's still small, so her other self didn't appear like everyone else. And she got caught in all the craziness. I hope she's okay.
Are the doctors going to be able to help her?
What? I'm worried about Nana-chan.
But there's nothing more we can do for her.
Honestly, no clue.
A delivery man named Namatame, the possibility of Nanako-chan being targeted. If only I'd been more thorough in putting the facts together, then Nanako-chan wouldn't have to go through this.
That goes for me too. If I hadn't stood there like a big lump in front of that bastard Nanako-chan, might have been okay.
I hate myself. Why must I do? Why do I always panic when it matters most? I couldn't do anything either. I should have noticed sooner that something was wrong with that guy.
Why did I waste my time listening to what Namatame had to say? If I hadn't tried to engage him in conversation, we'd rescued Nanako-chan immediately. This wouldn't have happened.
Don't blame yourselves. You really can't blame yourselves.
But I still...
Yeah, you can't blame yourselves, dudes. You really, really can't.
Alright, I know this pretty party. Just spin around and whining really what we ought to be doing now. Them done it controlling each other, they ain't gonna solve anything. You gonna believe in her.
True. Thank you, Kanji.
So stop rehashing what's already done, and get together tonight, Naoto.
You're absolutely right.
This is all this bastard Namatame's fault, and he's behind bars now, right? And it ain't like we're too late for Nanako-chan.
True.
Yeah, that's true.
I'll come see Nana-chan every day, so she'll be better faster.
That's all we can do right now. Gee, Kanji, you sounded cool for a second there.
True, Kanji, but you always sound cool, let's be honest. Oh, hey, Adachi.
You guys still here?
Dachi-san, did they find out anything?
Did they?
Dojima-san's speaking with the doctor now, but they can't say anything definite until they run some tests on her. Not just Nanako-chan, but the perp, too. Who knows when we'll be able to hear his story. Well, it's getting late, so hurry home. Last thing we need is for you guys to collapse, too.
True. Well, see you later, Adachi. Good to see you again. Also, thank you for letting us out, since you definitely could have just trapped us in that, interrogation room, let's be honest.
He's right. We should call it a night. Nanako-chan's gonna be fine. Acting all gloomy won't help anything.
True. It really wouldn't.
When Nanako-chan's out of the hospital, what should we do to celebrate?
Dude, isn't it a little early for that?
Why don't we reserve Juness and have a pretty bear?
Party at Juness? That makes no sense.
True, it really don't.
But
we could. She doesn't like Juness, so honestly it would be a good place to take her. What's up, Teddy?
Nanako-chan, she'll be getting better, right?
Just believe in her. True. Yeah, I'm believing her.
Yeah, I do believe in her. let's all have fun with Nanako-chan when she comes back.
Yeah, definitely. You sense Teddy's warm feelings for Nanako, and strong trust in you. Okay. And that also means a free rank up, so we'll definitely take that. Only one more for Teddy. And then he'll be finally woken to his true feelings. I wonder what his true feelings are going to look like, honestly. The Teddy social link has reached level 9. Your power creep personas of Star Arcana has grown as well. Teddy's determination in battle has been enhanced. He can now take a mortal blow for you in battle, which is also really nice.
Thanks. I almost forgot how to keep a happy face. But with that out of the way, I'm feeling all hungry.
you and your stomach. I'm guessing you're going to have some topsicles. Okay, we'll see you later.
Hey, where did everyone go? Don't leave without me.
Well, see you later, Teddy. Where to now, honestly? 404, which means error. But that's kind of a weird place to put Nanako, honestly. You've done everything you can. All you can do now is to believe in Nanako and wait for her to recover. So, would that mean this is the end of the chapter? Or, honestly, I don't know. In a municipal hospital, Dojima's room. Oh, we get to check up on Dojima too. We should probably tell him about Nanako. Why'd I say her? Dojima is both of their last names, and for some reason we call Dojima Dojima, even though his real name isn't even Dojima. It's some Ryotaro, isn't it? Or Rotaro, or however you say it. So yeah, it's still weird to call him Dojima and Nanako Dojima, but honestly, I'm getting used to it at this point.
He didn't go home yet.
Yeah, we didn't. Looks like we wanted to go tell Dojima what's going on and also check up on him. You tell Dojima that Nanako's safe.
I heard that.
No problem, Dojima. Dojima sighs deeply. We got him. We got that Namatame. No more delivery truck murders now.
Nanako, I'm so relieved.
Good. Now you just rest up, old man, and you get all better.
Dojima-san, you're awake. I guess it's no surprise. He was so stressed out over Nanako-chan.
Yeah, definitely.
I'll stay with him tonight. You can go home and rest, even if it's just for a little while.
I'll be alright. Yeah, I'll stay here with Dojima as well.
Please. You look terrible. Nanako-chan's safe, so relax. I think you should get some rest.
Okay. You sense Adachi's concern for you. Oh, we're finally getting rank ups for Adachi again. Okay, I'll take it. Rank 7 of the Jester. The Toru Adachi social link has reached level 7. Your power creep personas of the Jester Arcana has grown as well. So now it's finally going up again. I wonder why it took so long for his social link to start progressing again, since his has been completely locked out for quite some time.
Hurry and go. Your friends are waiting, aren't they?
Honestly, it could be because the investigation seems to be pretty much over now. So now he's able to kind of, like, hang out with us now that the investigation's all over. So it kind of makes sense now. But Dojima's was available throughout the entire game, but that was because he had to come home and rest, of course. So, that's pretty cool. So now we can start working on Adachi again. It's already late. He left Dojima and Adachi and went back. Okay. With that, let's head on back home. I'm guessing now is going to be where the save point comes up, and it is. So, with that, the next dungeon of the game is now over, leaving us with only so many left. And the next dungeon is technically the final one when it comes to, no, it isn't. It's, what is it, two more dungeons, I think it is? So we have the next dungeon, which is during the month of December, and that is going to be a major dungeon, because I think I don't think the final boss fight appears there, but it definitely is very close to the very end, because there's a one-day dungeon that literally is your whole day, and then it's over, and then the game is pretty much done from there, I think. I'm not exactly sure how it works exactly, but we are getting really close to the end of the game. So that's, honestly, I don't know how this game's going to end up wrapping up, since there is still a couple more months in the game. So we have December, January, February, and then March, and then the game is over, I believe. So that's only a couple months left in the game, and only a couple more dungeons. And of course, the Golden Dungeon is still not even in play yet. So that's, thank you all for watching this episode. Have a wonderful rest of your day. It's been a blast hanging out with you guys again, since it has been a couple days. And honestly, I think we kind of got through this pretty well. The rust did hit a couple times, especially during the boss fights, due to the fact that I didn't exactly expect the enemy to control my allies, and then force Chie to use a severe physical attack that was also charged up with the power charge. Yeah, definitely wasn't the funnest thing, and then we ended up losing our first boss fights of the game. But it makes sense, because we haven't had that happen yet, and honestly, I was kind of expecting it to happen at some point. But with that, thank you all for watching, have a wonderful rest of your day, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace out.
Hey, boys and girls, thank you all for watching today's episode. If you liked what you saw today, please leave a like and maybe even subscribe. And hit the bell notification down below. If you guys have any kind of suggestions for games, please put that in the comments down below as well. Thank you all for watching today's episode. And keep being spooky. Peace out, guys.